no water that's thicker than blood, that's deeper than love with my friends. People come and some people go and some people ride till the end. When I am blind in my mind, I swear they'd be my rescue, my lifeline. I don't know what I'd do if I'd survive. My brothers and my sisters in my life. I know some people, they would die for me. We run together, they're my family. When I get up, they gon' be high with me. I'll stay forever my family. Change, now we're grown. We're still young, still got our mindless ways in a timeless phase, kicking souls. When I am blind in my mind, I swear they'd be my rescue, my lifeline. I don't know what I'd do if I'd survive. My brothers and my sisters in my life. I know some people, they would die for me.
Thank you. time is running out. I'm talking here and now. I'm talking here and now.
It's not about what you've done, it's about what you do. It's all about where you're going, no matter where you've been. Let's go. Let's go.
I've walked through the valleys of the wilderness in time, only to find out that you have love in places I can't describe. I need you.
It's blinking. Is it still working? Okay. What's that? Yeah. Here we go. Quick mic check, mic check. Are we getting thumbs up over there? Drew, are we getting thumbs up? Drew, let me know. Can it hear me? All right. I can't see the screen, so I got to verify with Drew if we got the microphone working. You got to mute that one up. Can you hit the mute on there?
I said volume up.
This one's muted too. There we go. All right, guys. Well, good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Come on. Good morning.
Good morning.
All right. I got some checks here today, so that should get everybody excited. All right. So let's get into the notes, guys. We have a very special guest here today. And let's welcome him into the agency, guys. We have Mike Laramie in the house. Mike, come on up. We got a special seat for you right here. We got a special seat for you. You can hang out on the stage with us. Watch that. What do you call that thing? A hoverboard? Is that what it's called? Gio got a hoverboard for the office, guys. So if you ride that thing, you have to sign the waiver, all right? Because you break your arm or something. No liabilities over here. So, guys, we got a jam-packed meeting today, so we're going to get right into it. We have the quarterly awards. So first quarter award winners are going to get to hear from the best of the best in the agency speaking to us today. And also we have our special guest, Mike Laramie's in the house today, guys. He's going to be speaking to us as well. All right. So today is the last week of May. So you guys know every month we get how many weeks? 4 weeks. This month we have 5 weeks. So today, this week is bonus week. This is bonus. So if you had, if you missed your number, if you're behind for the month of May, this week is your chance to save your May. Save your May. You have a chance to save your May. Now, if you're already at your goal, then this is your chance to slay your May and just absolutely just crush your May. Either way, it's a chance to take care of business. Normally, we don't get this extra week. So once again, take advantage of this opportunity to close out the month. We've got some big commitments, some big goals for some people who want to do some big things and close out the month. So we only get one May of 2021. That's it. You're only going to get one of these months, and we're blessed to have an extra week. So let's take advantage of that. We have a flyer right around the wall over here on the other side for convention 2022. Everybody knows where convention is going to be next year. Where are we going?
Las Vegas,
right? So I'm proud to say that we've been to Las Vegas in 2018. We had a blast. We were on stage as the number one RGA in the company. But the biggest thing I was probably proud of is that we all went to Vegas and then everybody actually made it back from Vegas, right? So I'm excited to take a whole plane full of people next year. We have a goal to have 100 people at our convention. So if you If you're here, make sure you're on it, but make sure you sign up, tell your boss, tell your leader, tell your team, hey, tell your family members that you're next year you're going to be in Las Vegas in May for the company convention with us. Speaking of Las Vegas and convention, the goal every year is to qualify for convention by convention, right? So this year we had two people that are on the verge, they're on the cusp. They might have hit it, they might not, but that's what this week is all about because there's one more week left in May. We have two individuals that if they take care of business this month in May, they are going to qualify for a convention already for the year. Most people, you ever hear procrastination? Like people procrastinate, wait till the last minute to get stuff done. Well, not these individuals. They said, if I got homework, I'm going to do it on the way home on the bus. I'm not even going to wait home to get this done. So they got their business done in the first quarter, and it took them, 5 months to qualify. But I'll tell you, we have two people this year. And what we're going to do, guys, is we're going to have next to the flyer, once you qualify, there's going to be the list of qualifiers. So once you qualify, you're going to get your name up on the plaque. It's going to be the 2021 Convention Qualifiers plaque, right? And it's going to go in order of who qualifies first, right? So whoever qualifies first, boom, you get your name up on it, right? And by the end, we want to have at least 100 people on that plane ride with us going. So I'm really excited about that. However, if you guys don't know right now, the people are, and if you guys can get behind them, let's give them a major round of applause for putting themselves in this position. But we'll give them both at the same time. So right now we have Ashley, Miza, and Christina, Andy, already on their way. So we have some managers that are really close as well. I'd say pretty much within the next month or two, I have a couple other managers qualifying. So next week, the final results should be out, and we're going to be able to welcome them up on the stage and give them a real standing ovation for actually qualifying and hitting those numbers. But hats off, heck of a job, and compliments to you guys. Speaking of convention, while I was at Cancun, a lot of people were coming up to me, and they were saying stuff about the people in our agency. All right. I don't know if you believe what kind of stuff they were saying about the people in our agency, but one of the state directors came up to me and he said, Tommy, I met some people in your agency and they were the most amazing people I ever met. I'll tell you what, you got some really sharp people in your agency and on your team. And I'll tell you guys, that was the biggest compliment that I got all year. Was from people that didn't even know you guys, met you for the first time, and the impression that they got was above, to the point when they came up to me, it wasn't like, hey, Tommy, how you been? How's the family? It's like, hey, Tommy, I met some of your people. They're awesome. Like, those were the responses that I was getting. So I just wanted to let you guys know that we're there. A heck of a job, way to carry yourselves, and that stuff goes a long way, guys. So next year, you guys got to make sure we back it up again, except we're going to have 100 people there. So we're really going to make an impression on everybody. So without further ado, guys, we have some outstanding performances. Look at all these that come in. We got outstanding performances. We got recognition awards, and we got a bunch of checks to hand out. So let's bring up G.O. Vaca to break out the outstanding performances for the week.
Awesome.
So Mike Laramie is like, how do you spell G-O? And I was going to go into, I was like, G-I-O, like guaranteed insurability option, right? But if you really want to know how to spell G-O, you spell G-O, go. Because this dude's always on the go. You can't hold him down, right? So bring us in,
G-O. What an awesome. How's everybody doing right now? More time. How's everybody doing right now?
Let's go.
All right. Thank you. I don't even have a voice, so I don't know how I'm doing that. No, I'm kidding. All right. So can you guys hear me over here? Good. This microphone's here. Let me strap up here. All right. So we're going to announce the ALP, and then we'll follow up with the name, and we'll get a round of applause. So we have 10,798 Nets first 6 month production ALP. This is a team award here. It looks like it's Javon Braxton. Good job, brother. Hey, everybody, look at his beard coming in. Swishing up. I didn't even know it was him. All right. So we got 4,415. This is individual. We had Ryan Wilson. Ryan Wilson. Good job. I'll hold that one. Looking at this last name. Okay. So we got 6,027. Omar. Al-Curdy. Great job seeing him all over the group. Good job. This individual, hopefully I don't butcher this name. We have 4,770. Rogana. I just let you do all the hard work. All right, perfect. That concludes our outstanding performances. Good job. And then it does look like we got some paychecks here. These are renewals.
So right here it says renewal commission.
Yep, looks like they're renewals, remember. this is going to be a monthly consecutive paycheck on top of our weekly paycheck. We have an extra $1,326. Wow, going to Christina Andy. Woo! Good job, girl. Wow, an extra $1,300. Wow, this individual again, $1,106. Javon Braxton. Let's go, Jay. Good job, buddy. Good job, man. Awesome. Super proud of you. We have an extra $100.98. So an extra $100. We have Demetrius. Let's go, Demetrius. All right. We have an additional $106. Lita. Go, Lita. Good job. Wow. Look at this. An extra $637. Might as well round up because it's an 85 cents. Might as well say 638. We have Marissa. Yeah. Come up and get your money. Good job, Marissa. Oh,
look at that. Let me make sure. Yeah, that's right.
All right. This individual, we had $516 extra dollars. Steven Ellis. Yeah. Let's go, Steven. Woo! Good job, brother.
Your
car payment?
There you go.
Ah, there we
go. Car payment's more than 500?
No.
It's less. So that pays for your car?
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. Pays for a car payment. Not too bad, right? We have an extra $196. Jackie Gilbert. Woo! Good job, Jackie. Love it. All right, an extra $123, Roy Gross. Good. Okay, all right, cool. All right, an extra $31, Jeremy Herring. Let's give it up for Jeremy. All right, now we're getting there. We got $296. Super proud of you, bro. Matt Hunsberger. Good job, buddy. Let's go. There we go. He's got it. All right. Almost $400. We have $398. We have Faith. Who? Faith Jones. Let's go, Faith. Start your stuff, girl. All right. Look at this. $839 extra dollars. Vincent Masseri. Woo. Almost 800.
Is that 800?
I don't know. Is it?
Is it
839?
Yeah. What did I just say this morning?
Job forms.
There we go. The house
money. Let's go. Love it. Love it. We have an extra $101. Alex Mondragon. All right. I'm gonna grab that. We got one of the seven brothers coming up to get it. No, I'm just kidding. Oh, and what a coincidence. We had $236. You might as well stay up here, Marvin. We got Brian Mondragon. Oh, and hey, you might as well stay up here again. We have another Mondragon. We have $354. Marvin, what's your head game?
Woo! It went 1, 2, 3?
It went 1, 2, 3, yeah.
Right? So Alex got 100, Brian got 200, Marvin got 300.
Yep, yep. Wow, look at this. Woo! $2,833. We have Ashley Miza. Woo! Come on. Almost $3,000.
So this wow. is not her weekly paycheck. We get paid every single week. This is her one-time monthly renewals that we get on top of our paycheck. And Ashley's been here for a little bit over a year, clearing $2,800 a month.
Let's go. That's what I'm talking about. That's awesome. All right, we have another big one. We have 1,695. We have Melissa Nugent. Woo! Extra $1,700. Let's go. All right, extra $24. Not too bad. Get yourself an extra coffee or two. We have, looks like Charles. Charles. All right. An extra 178. Look at this. Richard. Chuck. Let's go, Rich. Love it. All right, you ready for this next one? We have an extra $1,210. Joshua Yurinko. Let's go. Last but not least, we have an extra $269 going to Omar. All right. I think that concludes all the money. We're out of money. All right, let's give another round of applause over here. All right, let's do it.
Okay. So what a coincidence. How about the shirt, right? The power of residual income. So if you wanted to generate what Ashley generates in residual income, which is $2,800 a month, $2,800 a month is how much? It's about $30,000 a year, right? To get $30,000 a year in residual income, how much money would you have saved up? You got it. Who said a million? Steve Ellis. All right, man. You heard this one before. Come on. Yeah, here. You get a box of Cracker Jacks, my man. Hey. Hey, we got Cracker Jacks. This is the last day for the Take Me Out to the Ball Game contest. So get your peanuts and Cracker Jacks and come down and sing the seven, what is it called? The seventh inning stretch with Harry Carey. That's classic right there. That's worth the price to admission alone. So yes, the answer, guys, is if you had $1 million saved up, you can retire with 3% a year, which would be $30,000, which is $2,500 a month. Last time I checked, Ashley's was $2,800. So she's been here for a little over a year. I don't know where you could go in a year and have $1 million saved up in your 401k, right? So that's the power of residual income. If you're wondering what this means, that's what it means, okay? We also had a couple things come in. I'm gonna have to open these up. Can you help me open these, Josh? Yeah, that's an old one. We already gave that out. Here's DJ Afterthought. We got Ryan Haynes, DJ Afterthought, just hit his 1 year anniversary. So if you see him, congratulate him. And he just got a new song that came out, so you go follow him. Let's go. 1 year, new song. All right. How about these artists, right? Making hits. We got this guy, 1 year in the business, making hits. Javon Braxton. 1 year anniversary, man. Proud of you. The 1 year anniversary plaque. What do you get? What are you getting there? Open that up. Let everybody know. We got another one. 1 year anniversary. What are some things you get to pick for the 1 year, guys? If you go in here, you get a watch. I think you get a fishing rod. You could get a suitcase. You get a TV. I mean, whatever your likings are. My dad got the watch. It's actually pretty fancy. This is his, what the claim is, I think it's true, right? This is the first person that has ever been hired in our agency. Literally, the first person that we ever hired. And he just hit his 1 year anniversary today. What a special day, man. Tommy Whalen. Yes, sir, man. Howdy, bro. Okay. All right. We handed those out. We don't have the Google reviews for today, so we're going to hold those off till next week. Okay. And we're going to slide into our quarterly award winner. So for the first quarter of 2021, we're going to hear from our top agent, supervisor, GA, and MGA going to speak here today. So starting with our top agent for the first quarter, we definitely had some major performances, but she started out the year on fire. She crushed it in January. She won our tournament in January. She won $2,000 on top of everything else that month, and she won our first round knockout. And then she also came to play in March, and she won our March Madness tournament. So if you haven't guessed already, the agent of the quarter, and she's just getting started, is Ashley Miza.
Hey guys, can you all hear me? Can you guys hear me okay? And you guys can see me okay? All right, guys. So this was a little bit unexpected that I was going to speak today. So I'm just going to kind of share from my heart, try to keep this as short and concise as possible. I do really, really appreciate everybody that's gotten me to where I'm at today. I'm not going to lie and say that I've done it alone. I mean, Tommy laid this foundation. And I mean, if you guys are brand new and you haven't gotten to know Tommy yet, he's incredible. He's helped me think bigger. He's helped me believe in myself. He's helped me set bigger goals. Casey, he's always been accessible. He's always been there. He's helped me so much with back end of business, helping that, questions, always there. And, I appreciate him so much. Gio and Vince, I mean, they coached me and taught me everything I needed to know about sales. And I'm not even on Vince's team right now, and he's still there for me all the time. He's still answering phone calls when I'm stuck in a sit and helping me out. And I just appreciate that so, so much. And now, more recently, I've been working closer and closer with Austin, and I'm so excited for the future. It's a game changer. I mean, from the beginning, I mean, she always helped me. She always led the way. And guys, she's not up here getting recognized as top agent, but I mean, she's one of the best we have in this agency when it comes to closing. Her closing ratio is like the highest. I mean, she's just a selfless person. She puts her team before herself, and her focus isn't on producing. And that's why I'm up here, not her. But anyways, I can't go ahead and talk about why I did what I did without giving credit to the people who got me to where I'm at first. And I'm just going to share something short and sweet that's going to hopefully add value to your guys' life and hopefully take your guys' business to the next level. So, I mean, this is going to sound very, very simple and very, very redundant, guys, but mind, body, spirit. It's so simple, but how many of us actually on this call actually have the discipline to apply that every single day? I mean, I know that I didn't. I mean, what drove me to work so hard, what drove me to continue to have the results that I did was the belief that God called me here and the vision he gave me to use this vehicle to make an impact in other people's lives. And that's what drove me to continue going and going and going. However, I mean, I'm going to be completely honest with you guys. I mean, I did have results throughout the first quarter of the year, but they were nowhere near where they could be, where they should be. I mean, what I did was nothing. And the reason why was I didn't have the focus on my mind, body, and spirit like I needed to. And what I came to the realization of last month, because I did struggle last month. Last month was, I mean, everybody has setbacks, even me up here. You see me doing well in the first quarter. I struggled a little bit last month. And what I came to the realization is that, I mean, I wasn't enough to do it on my own because I was trying so hard to do everything and walk out the vision that God had given me without focusing on my mind, body, and spirit. And that's what was missing. I realized that I have a lot of flaws, guys, but the positive thing about that is when we focus on our mind, body, spirit, I mean, in scripture, and I'm not here to push my beliefs on anybody here today, but it says that God's power works best in our weakness. So what I realized last month is that I didn't have to be enough. I didn't have to do it all. All I had to do was make a shift, a mental shift. I had to start being more disciplined with the mind, body, spirit aspect. And I mean, I got connected with a church that was a little bit more spiritual. I've been growing in that. I'm not perfect on that. But I mean, the thing is last week, I had my biggest week ever and netted 16-2, and I didn't work as hard as I did in March to get those results. There's something to be said about God's favor on your life. And I'm not saying this to evangelize on you guys. I mean, I'm not saying this to say that you need to be a Christian, but what I'm saying is that it's so, so important that we have a focus on those areas of our life as well. I mean, regardless of what it is, regardless of what it is that we struggle with, I mean, if it's self-discipline, if it's focus, if it's vision, if it's big, if it's thinking bigger, if we focus on the spiritual aspect of our life, God, I mean, or whatever spiritual force that you believe in, he's going to help you to overcome those things. That's how we make it through adversity. That's how we do amazing things. There's only so much that we can do alone. And that's for everybody on this call. And I mean, it's just, like I said, you don't have to be anything special. You don't. I promise you, I promise everybody on this call that you guys all probably have more talent, more ability than I do. The difference is the reason why I was the top producer of the top quarter was because I was just here a little bit longer than you guys and I worked nonstop. But that's nothing. That's nothing. I mean, now moving on the rest of the year, the last 6 months of the year, you guys haven't seen anything yet. And it doesn't have to just be me, guys. Put in the work, focus on your mind, body, spirit, and you guys are going to be right there along with me. I promise you. And I mean, 50K is going to be a bad month for all of you guys on this call. But yeah.
Are we good? Wow. Ashley, that might have been the best yet from Ashley. And she said the best is yet to come. So I can't wait to see what's in store. I already know what her mind's getting wrapped around right now. And thank you for just letting everybody see what's possible and sharing your secrets, guys. The secret's out now, right? It hasn't been a secret that everybody knows, mind, body, spirit. So she's just applying a little bit more. So great job, Ashley. And now we're going to go to our supervisor for the first quarter. Talk about selfless, talk about a hard worker, talk about a leader. He was leading the way from the time he came into the door. And coachable, great, just human being, good son, wants to just make his mom and dad proud and take care of his family. And what more could you ask for in that, right? And he definitely earned it. He earned his promotion to a GA by being the number one SA for the first quarter. That's how you do it, right? So you can only be an SA once, and he put it to rest by ending the first quarter as the number one SA for us for the whole entire quarter, got himself promoted to a GA, and he promoted two people to SAs at the same exact time. Mr. Reich Hussein.
I appreciate all the kind words, Tommy, man. Let me mic you up.
Oh, for sure, for sure.
Boom.
What's up, guys? Can you guys hear me? For sure. Honestly, everyone always says this because it's so true. This is a team award. Thank you, Tommy, for all the nice words. I don't even say that many nice things about myself, so that was fire. But yeah, guys, definitely a team award. I really would not be here without anyone on my team, and even on like Hunzi's team, because I see like all the people on our MGA squad work hard and makes me want to work harder. All it was for us to really get here was kind of like what Ashley said. We were just really on top of being here a little bit longer, working harder in that mind, body, spirit. We never really gave up. There was a lot of times where people want to give up. You know, I don't know if you guys know this. I've wrecked my car like 4 times driving around here. If you want to give up, it's 4 times after wrecking your car. And we just never give up. I always say it's not my fault. It's just because everyone else is a bad driver. But that's just for me. You know, I wrecked my car 4 times and we just never gave up. And I remember talking to my team and literally just being like, guys, what are we going to do? Like, what's the next step? Like, what's the next step for us to become? Because when we were agents, we were looking at that MGA position already. We were like, how do we get here right away? And I think that's the main reason that we ended up becoming top essays. So big shout out to my boy, Marv. That's my right-hand man. Big shout out to my girl, Faith. And that's my left hand. I always say this too, if these guys aren't in order, I'll walk around stupid because they're flailing around everywhere. But those guys are like my rocks right there. And then I got my boy, man, Reed, you know, one of my best friends, just came in from college to work with us here. He's going to crush it. We got all the other people, Brian, Alex, Eric Berrio, Sheely, Celis, even like Gio's team, like Christina and Marquise. When I see them rocking, I get angry at myself. I'm like, why am I not rocking as hard as these guys are? So these guys are motivation as well too. Of course, Hunzi. Hunzi's my guy. I ask him hella questions all the time. A lot of questions all the time. Most importantly, my boy Vince, dude, I was here last night till like 1 a.m. or 12 o'clock just bugging Vince with questions. To this day, if you don't go to your manager and ask them questions, you're not going to get anywhere in life. Like, I promise you, bug them. If they're saying you're annoying, you're doing a good job because you're supposed to be annoying. And then most importantly, Gio. Gio's my guy. Like, I was in the bathroom earlier. He's like, hey, man, you got an award today. I was like, wow, in the bathroom. But he's my guy, dude. I literally ask him for everything and anything. Anytime I have problems, anything, like, with the business, anything I can come, like, anything I can think of, whether it's recruiting, ALP, or even just managing my team, he has the answer for it. So if you guys ever do have questions, reach out to the top dog here, Mr. RGA. But other than that, guys, that's really all it was. Thanks. Shout out to my team again. And all it is just working hard, guys. Woo! I don't know how to do this off.
Thank you, guys. I'm proud of you.
All right. Top essay. You see why it was so successful there. And Gio, he's a PPS. We'll get to him in a minute. But that's a professional problem solver. Right. So you got some problems, just bring it to him and he'll solve it at a professional level for you. Moving on to our GA. Wow. Our top GA and our top MGA for the first quarter of the year. We're going to go into next. So our top GA, she came into the business last year and moved out here and surprised us and said she wanted to do the business. I thought she was just gonna move out here and help a little bit on the side. And she said, no, I'm getting licensed. I'm coming in, I'm doing the business. I'm like, okay. And she was able to recruit and build a team. And that's one thing, right? To recruit, but then to be able to go out and hop on these Zoom calls and set appointments and hop on these Zoom calls and crush numbers consistently since she's been in here is a whole nother thing. And then to put it all together and to be able to lead a team, lead yourself, okay? And also, I'm going to let you guys know that she is a GA, but her MGA is also her boyfriend, okay? So to be able to manage a relationship inside, outside of business is something very, 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 very special. So you guys got just something very special going on, and there's no doubt about it. Melissa, you're very talented, extremely special. She puts her mind to something. Watch out. Like, watch out. She says she's going to do something. She is going to do it. And she's going to do it to the best. And I mean, she worked all last year, built her team up, got herself to the GA position. And in the first quarter of last year, was our number one GA in the entire agency. So without further ado, guys, let's have her come up and speak. Congratulations to number one GA first quarter 2021, Melissa Nugent.
All right. Can you guys hear me? Oh, yeah. You guys can see me as well? Right. All right. Now, of course, just want to make sure here. Prove it by giving me the quality control number, guys. Oh, I'm just kidding. inside joke, you guys know the script, of course. but more or less, guys, first off, of course, I always wanted to start off, of course, just thanking God, because without him, I truly wouldn't be where I am without his guidance and just giving me another day to deliver my purpose. And of course, second, like I said before, this honestly isn't just about me up here. It's about the team, to all the hard work and dedication behind the scenes that this team does. This reward honestly speaks for itself as well. So honestly, just a quick couple shout outs to all who was able to make this happen. Of course, Tommy, I will never stop thanking you, of course. You show up every single day to lead us by example. Because of you, the Opportunity Unlimited is here to help protect families and just reach our goals and dreams. And of course, Gio. I mean, Tommy speaks well of it enough for us all. But Gio, I can never say enough. Thank you for pouring your all into me. I mean, you did brought me in, and I can say you pour all into me so I can pour into others, and you taught me everything I need to know. Push me to my max potential every single day. Truly blessed to have you by my side, always and forever, we always say. Christina, my girl, super proud of you. I mean, the queen of consistency. You're always thriving. Just keep it up and keep on rocking it. Marquise, where's that smile, Marquise? I know you're smiling right now as I say this. Super proud of you, overcoming and achieving all that comes to your way. Just keep on rocking it. Vivian and Gina, I mean, you guys have achieved so much in a short amount of time as is. And guys, this is just the beginning. Super proud of how far you came. Can't wait to see you. Can't wait to see you guys do what else. I mean, just keep on rocking it too. And also, lastly, Sydney Styler. I see you, girl. First day today. Get ready. Big things are coming your way on this team and at the Vena Agency. I can't wait to see you rock it as well. This is the team, one dreams. So of course, more or less to wrap it up here real quick for you guys. Just a real quick thought to share for you all is that, I mean, a majority of you guys probably have heard this line. I wish I was in your shoes. And this specific line came up a lot to me while I was at convention. I know we talk about convention a lot, but that's the thing, of course, is that, of course, out of all the times I hear it is when I'm at the pool or at the beach sipping on a pina colada, right? Now, I honestly never heard, I wish I was in your shoes when I was working on a Saturday night at 11 p.m. I don't know who else can say that, but that's the thing. And this question comes to mind is, are you willing to sacrifice the good times now for the extraordinary times later? Because that's what the Opportunity Unlimited is about. And what that statement truly means is sacrificing those short-term pleasures of all their Saturday nights, bar hopping for the ultimate victories in the long term, such as all the exclusive paid trip like to Cancun. That's what it's all about, guys. I mean, it's easier said than done. To achieve any greatness in any field takes a relentless work ethic and doing what you hate to do, but do it like you love it. So decide today and every day. Is reaching your goals more important than indulging in small time pleasures? Think about it and never stop learning and growing, everyone. Thank you.
Great job, Melissa. You spoke very, very well on top of that. So you guys know the apple don't fall too far from the tree in this situation, but our number one MGA for the first quarter of last year came out and rocked it. And just like we knew we would, always leading from the front, always extremely coachable. And I'm just extremely proud of Gio for everything that you've done, man, moving out here, having the trust and the faith in me. And he's coachable as they come. I got to tell you, he always says, you know, he'll text me back. And like, if I read through, sometimes I'll just go through our conversations. You ever go back through a conversation with somebody, right? And it's like, you're right. Like, you know, he's coachable. He don't even think twice. Like, yep, you're right. I'll do that. No problem on it. Talk about accessibility. You know, they say two of your best abilities can be your accessibility and your reliability. Are you accessible? And are you reliable? Right? Those don't really require much skill set, though. You don't got to be good at math. You don't got to be fast. You don't got to run a 4.3. You got to be accessible and reliable. When somebody needs you, can they get to you? And when they get to you, can they rely that you're going to come through for them? Well, every single time I call Gio, he either answers the phone or he gets right back to me immediately with a text message or an answer or a call. He's extremely accessible. And anytime that the agency has needed anything for the last 5 years, we call on Gio. He gets in his car and he'll be like, all right, I'll be gone for the next 10 days, Tommy, but I'll come back and we're going to win. And we've had competitions where it was our team versus other teams. Vince was on that. Drew was there. Casey was there. Josh was there. Where our team got called out against other teams. And we had to rally up. Vince rallied up. Josh rallied up. Drew rallied up. Casey rallied up. Gio always rallied up and delivered the results. So when we got to come out here, I couldn't think of someone better to ride or die with than Gio, man. So he's like family, he's like a brother. And when I say a good kid who loves his mom and dad, just like Reich, you're looking at him right here, man. Just a great, 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 great man to have on your side, guys. So our number one MGA for the first quarter, man. Proud of you, bro. Mr. Gio Vacca.
Appreciate you, Doc. Awesome, awesome. All right. Definitely give a quick shout out to all the speakers. Let's give them another round of applause. Good job, guys. Awesome job. Sounded great. Seriously, every time you guys come up here, you sound better and better and better. That's the whole goal of getting up here, so you sound better every time. Okay. Now, first and foremost, you know, definitely have to thank God, guys. He graced me with many blessings that are far above my control. We wouldn't be here today if it wasn't for that. Thank you, Tommy. You know, you could have stayed in Pittsburgh, man, and probably would have been good. You know, like we all talked about, you probably would have been good and fine. And the fact that he was able to go through another, you know, year, 2 years, 3 years of suffering and struggling so that he can have a better future for himself, obviously, but for you guys to lay out that foundation for you guys is truly honorable. You know what I mean? So thank you, man, for always, you know, sacrificing for us. Melissa, you were able to hear her speak, sounding great. You're my ride or die. You know, it's never going to change. I can trust her with freaking anything. Anything, she's always going to be there. I don't care what it is, she's always there. And you know, I really, really thank and appreciate you more than you know. You know, Austin, Christina, Marquise, Ashley, Ryan, the leaders, you guys literally just anything, talk about coachable. If I went through the text messages with Christina and Marquise, it'd be like on it, done. Yep. I already sent an email. Like, it's just super coachable. I appreciate you guys. And, you know, honestly, someone like Ashley, who's a top performer, already rocking it. And you're about to see her do something huge. She's going for $100,000 a month. Definitely appreciate you. Ryan, congratulations. Just got promoted. Can't wait to see what you're about to do. You know, we got Zach, Matt, Gina still has the record for the longest third interview I've ever done in my entire life. It's like 4 hours or something crazy like that. And, you know, we ended up while we were on Zoom, we went to dinner and then we went to, no, I'm just kidding. No, it was a long one. But we have Vivian and Indira. Didn't even get started yet. You guys are rocking. I really appreciate you guys. I want to be a little bit quicker because I know we got Mike is going to be able to speak. Every time I say your name, I want to say Mike Lowry from Bad Boys, but sounds so similar. But all right, quick message for you guys. All right. So here it is, guys. You guys are going to have to start looking at change a little bit differently. Okay. That's the message. You are going to have to start looking at change differently. You know, people come up to me and they tell me this. They say, Gio, it's hard to grind, right? It's hard to be disciplined. It's hard to stay grinding when everybody else is partying. It's hard to stay hungry. It's hard to stay motivated. It's hard to sacrifice. But you want to know what else is hard? It's hard to be broke, okay? It's hard to be depressed. It's hard to be governed by anxiety. It's hard to be inconsistent. It's hard to lack confidence. It's hard not believing in yourself. It's hard to be poor. It's all hard. You got to choose your heart. okay? And at the end of the day, you're either going to work for it or you're going to let life knock you on your ass, all right? But you need to understand, guys, that change is not a bad thing. Change is not at all. People look at change like it's a struggle. Change is pain, all right? Charles Darwin, he said it best, right? He said it wasn't those animals that were the most beautiful, the strongest, the heaviest, the fastest, that lived the longest, right? It wasn't that. It was those that changed. It was those that were adaptable. Those were the ones that lived the longest, okay? So you have to look at change like it's an evolution, right? In leadership, you have to change who you are for who you want to be, okay? Because at the end of the day, if you don't change as a leader, if I don't change, there will be generations of people that will be affected by me not changing, right? So in leadership, you have to change who you are, like I said, for who you want to become. And I'll end on this, okay? You're either evolving for the better or you're going to change for the worse. You need to decide. But change is an invitation to your future. If I can adapt, if I can change, I can have my future. All right, guys, that's all I got. Let's go. Come on. Let's go, baby. Come on.
Thank you, sir. Okay, guys. So we have our special guest here, and we're going to get right to it. Mike Lowry in the house, right? Mike flew in this morning from Texas. He lives right down in Texas. He works at our home office. But Mike's been with the company for 17 years. 17 years, and you guys know this is dog years here. Yeah. So whatever 17 times 7 is, that's really how long you've been here, okay? And Mike, he started out just where you guys started out, right? You signed your agent contract. He signed his agent contract, same contract we all signed. We come in, and he worked his way from a supervisor to a GA. Got a couple people got promoted to GAs, a couple supervisors where he just did. He worked to an MGA. Then he worked all up to a RGA, and he wasn't just, there's a lot of RGAs, but there's only a few top RGAs in the company. And he worked his way all the way up to be a consistent top RGA in the company year in and year out. And a few years ago, our CEO, Steve Greer, he was still an SGA 6 years ago, right? 5 years ago? When did he get promoted? Five?
January 1st, 2016.
So exactly about five years ago, Steve Greer got promoted to the CEO of our company. Prior to that, he was the SGA in Texas, in Houston, Texas. And his main RGA, his right-hand man, was Mike Laramie. So Mike Laramie was working hand-in-hand, side-by-side, the CEO as his main RGA. And I don't know, maybe it was maybe a year or 2 years after Steve Greer got promoted to CEO that he just kept working on Mike, I think. He kept working on him and finally got him to come to home office. So he convinced Mike to you know, give up being the RGA in Houston and convinced him to come become the head of our entire company's quality and retention. Talk about a main job and responsibility. And what I've heard recently, and he could give you the better statistics on this, but the Don Bertini, the vice president of our company, stated our company last month had an all-time high in quality and retention on almost every aspect of the business. And you're looking at the man who led the charge on that, guys. Give it up for Mike Laramie, and head of quality and retention. Maybe Mike can share some more stats and everything if I can mic you up real quick, yeah. Man. Thank you for coming to visit.
Yeah, us too, yeah. We thank really you, Tommy. Thank you. You. Really yeah, do. All good.
So how do I follow that up? Right. You know, so, hey, what? Good afternoon. I'm on Texas time. I'm all messed up. But good afternoon. Yeah. Love it. Love it. So, you know, I just wanted to go through because there's some people like if you've been here right under a year or if you ever has done a sale other than virtual, meaning or, you know, meaning you have you been out in the field? Who has not ever like been out in somebody's house? Right. Like just strictly just all virtual. Right. You know, 100% virtual. OK. You know, and Gio was talking about change. Right. And one thing I can tell you is guaranteed in your life is change. And, you know, we just made a huge change last year and we didn't know we were going to go through this. But, you know, who could have ever predicted the pandemic? Right. And it's changed our world forever. So I want to walk you through. And as Tommy mentioned, so I've been with the company for in June, it will be 17 years. You know, and talk about, you know, people talking about mind, body, spirit, and being blessed. I've been extremely blessed. But I can tell you it wasn't easy, you know, and whatever you're going to go through, it's never going to be easy. I can guarantee you this, you know, change, but I can guarantee you, you're going to work hard wherever you work. But, you know, the fifth paycheck of the month that people got today, you know, that is worth it, right? And let me give you a scenario. So if I said, you know, you came to work, you did an interview, and I said, hey, I guarantee you in 5 years from now, you're going to work, I mean, you're going to work like no tomorrow. But in 5 years, I'll pay for your car payment for the rest of your life. Who's in on that? Okay. And then 10 years from now, but you're going to go through ups, downs, all arounds. But 10 years, after 10 years, you're going to have the opportunity, right? So one is you're going to have a choice at 10 years saying, all right, I'm fully vested. And then you're going to have options. But you're going to work hard. But after that 10 years, I'm going to be able to sign a contract to pay for your car payment and your house payment. Who's in on that? So I'm telling y'all, that is the opportunity you have right now. You know, and we all talk about renewals, but I'm living proof, 100%, no lie. You know, renewals. I mean, they just came in, what, last week? You know, everybody's posting Happy Renewal Day. And talk about blessed. I'm not going to tell you my renewals, but after 14 years, right? There, I'm okay. There are six figures. So that's not to brag or boast. I can tell you, or God would take it straight back from me. But I can tell you, talk about being blessed. But I worked hard. Was there times I wanted to quit? Hundreds of times I probably wanted to quit, right? And you're going to get, I mean, even tonight, you're going to go, like, your friends are out partying and you're in phone setting on Zoom, you know, with people. But I can tell you, and as Mike Vasu, and he was one of my mentors. So I worked with Greer, you know, started from the bottom. I took a chance. So I moved all Texas, but I moved from Austin, uprooted my family, moved to Houston. I left a six-figure job, company car expense account, all that, stock options. People thought I was crazy. So one, go out in the field and write paper apps nights and weekends, right, and start from scratch. So one, everybody signed the same contract. You signed the same. Actually, your contract from 04 to now is much better. You know, they've increased the percentages, all that, but everybody signed the same contract. It's just what you do with that contract, you know? So, but I want to walk you through, like, you know, they always say, hey, back in the day, right? Back in the day, we walked both ways in the snow, right? Uphill, all that. Imagine this. So one, back in the day, flip phones. So there's no smartphones that are dumb. Number two, no GPS, right? Using a key map. So I physically had to go to Sam's and get a Collin County, Houston County, Montgomery County key map. Okay, and then you're going through manual leads, no impact back then, manually flipping through, just calling people. Okay, setting up an appointment, getting there, you're at 123 Mockingbird Street, okay? And then I've got a key map, I'm like, all right. So then you're doing everything on paper. You get to, I mean, if you can find the house, right? You get to the house, knock on the door, go in, sit down with husband and wife, and then you're working off what they call a rate book. So you're like, all right, how old are you? Okay, how old are you? Okay. And then you're flipping through the rate book and they're like, what the freak is this guy doing? Right? So you're doing a pitch book, you know, all that. And then what will mess you up is if their ages are way different. You know, you got a 52-year-old married to a 34-year-old, then you're flipping 52, okay, writing that. And then going to, you know, so imagine that. And then you had to have about 10 calculators, right? You had to sit there with the calculator and figure out rates, right? And their age. So imagine that. So fast forward to today. One, it's virtual. So you don't have to put over 100,000 miles on your car now in a year. Gas, no gas, virtual. So you get somebody on the line, you do virtual in your boxers, make sale and make money. Right? Talk about, I can tell you, being at the right place, at the right time, with the right agency, I mean, I promise you it doesn't get any better than that. So I will send you out for one day and say, hey, let me get your phone. All right, I'll give you a flip phone and I'll give you a key map. And after the first appointment, I guarantee you, you're gonna open up your sunroof, throw out the key map and say, screw this, right? I mean, trying to find somebody's house, you know, you're running off the road, you know, trying to find their house on a key map and, all right, am I here and knocking on the wrong house? What? No, I'm, oh, shoot, sorry. Hey, you need insurance? All right, no, but, right? So, I mean, imagine that. So just go back, you know, about change. So over a year ago now, you know, we changed to virtual and I can tell you, the company, you know, they pivoted. I mean, they changed the world forever and virtual's gonna here to stay. It's gonna be probably a mixed type of deal because believe it or not, there's some of those people, you know, career agents that simply like, I can't do the virtual. I don't wanna do it. I wanna go face to face, hard, knock on doors. And I was like, okay, but I can tell you, virtual, one, you can be much more effective than ever before. You can get in a lot more appointments and, you know, make a lot more money. The contract has increased, right, than back in the day. And then renewals. I'm seeing renewals go climb bigger than they ever have. You know, and Tommy's talking about stats, right? You know, I'm a big, like, numbers. I can analyze your numbers, all that. And, you know, writing business is good. But, you know, it's two things. One, it's not really how much you write. It's how much you keep. You want to get renewals. I mean, it's better to write a $50 deal a month that's going to stay on the books forever than a $100 deal that's going to pay 3 months and wreck your retention quality. Then you go off bonus. Then you miss convention, you know, all that. It causes a chain reaction. You know, so I would just say, you know, one, when you're meeting with clients, without a doubt, you know, you're going to go through introduction, all that. And then at the end of the EOP, you know, it walks you through, hey, there's always a chance for a physical, right? Clients, just like you, don't like surprises, right? Unless it's like a new house or money or a new car, right? But meaning you've got to prep them on every single scenario. You know, one, they will get a call from Waco, right? Do you tell them that or keep it a surprise? Number two, they, no matter what, there's a possibility of an exam. So meaning somebody, a nurse comes to your house, knocks on your door and does an exam in your house at your convenient, no cost to you? Do you tell them that? Also, do you, I always say check the pulse, right? You know, meaning when you wrap up and it's a $100 program, you know, are you making sure? You've got to think long-term that this, you know, one, it's not for you, it's for your children, even your children's children. So you want renewals to continue to come in each and every month for the rest of your life, but also you want to leave a legacy for your kids, right? And your hard work right now is doing that. But you need the policies to stay on the books the rest of their life. You know, so has there been maybe some times that you got off the phone, you're like, I don't know if this policy is going to stay on the books, right? Maybe one, maybe two, right? Don't raise your hand, right? But so with confidence, you know, when before you get off the phone, I always say love the one you're with, right? You know, you can spend an extra 5-10 minutes with that somebody because they're, I mean, you're on a Zoom call with them for an hour, right? And they're paying a monthly payment for the rest of their life. You can spend another few minutes on because I can tell you, you're going to possibly have a no-show. So don't rush off to get off that appointment to go to your next one for a no-show or an uninsurable, right? So also, you know, one is like giving clients a summary sheet, you know, one of what they've got, you know, especially in a virtual world. I mean, you're not physically meeting with them, you know, leaving a folder, right? So they need to know what they got. You know, they like the touchy feely, like, you know, you buy a car, you want to, right, see it, touch it, feel it. Well, we're not in that. I mean, this is like long-term, you know, stuff. So I'm a big advocate, and I took this off somebody's desk, but, you know, sending a thank you card, right? This business is a matter of inches, inches, and every policy counts. Does anybody know what ALP stands for? Oh, okay. Another life protected, right? Another life protected. But, you know, you've got to do the small things up front to keep that policy on a lifetime. So sending a thank you card. I know it's tiny. It's a stamp. But let me walk you through this scenario of sending a thank you card. One, just say on every single deal, you send a handwritten thank you card to the client. Now, if you need verbiage, I've got verbiage of what to put in it, or you can just Google, like, what do you say to people that buy life insurance and say, thank you, right? But make it personable, you know, meaning I say, hey, you know, thank you for enrolling and protecting your family for the rest of your life, da da da. But then P.S., something you got off the Zoom call with them. Good luck, little Johnny, on his soccer game in 2 weeks or state or something. They're like, they were listening to me. One, so sending a thank you card. Just say you send out 100 thank you cards. How many of those clients you think would are going to call you back and say, thank you for sending me a thank you card? Just say low ball it, five out of 100, right? I think it would be more, but just low ball, being conservative. So 5 out of 100 say thank you for sending a thank you card. And if you got one referral out of those five, because they go, oh, by the way, I know you talked about my cousin. I talked to my cousin and my cousin wants some insurance. You're like, all right, you're right. So just say you out of that 100, you send out 100, five people call you and say thank you for sending the thank you card and you get one referral out of that, one sale. That pays for the stamps on all those 100. I mean, that pays for itself. Number one. Number two, do you think, like, who's ever bought a house or bought a car or just gotten a handwritten thank you card, right? Did it make an impact on you, right? Same premise. I mean, this isn't a house or a car, but like a crazy thing. I went in December on a fully guided outfit duck hunting, right, deal in Oklahoma, and they sent me a flipping thank you card. I'm like, holy, I kept it. I'm like, all right, what? I mean, it was, right, it was off the charts, huh? But they sent me you know, a thank you card. So if you said yes, it will make an impact on you, right? Just imagine the impact. And then if it keeps one more policy on the books each month, right, then you're golden. So, you know, just that's a quick tip doing that. But you got to be consistent. You know, everybody says, hey, you got to be, I mean, hard work. You got to be organized, but you got to be consistent on it as well. So I worked with Greer, you know, for years. And then when Greer went to home office, I stayed and helped Mike Vasu. So if anybody knows Mike Vasu, you know, he's big into, he's got the hat and all that. And he registered sacrifice creates opportunity. So, and it truly is. I mean, sacrifice creates opportunity. So, but this business, you know, you don't have to make it hard. I mean, yes, it's hard, but really it's easy. I mean, it's not scientific. Anybody can do it if you're willing to do it, all right? And Mike always says this business comes down to four things, right? RTMQ. You know, you've got to recruit or develop. You got to train, management development. And the last thing is quality. So you got to keep the business on the books. And you've got to manage that and be organized about it, right? So those are the four pillars of the business, right? So, and I can tell you, I mean, everybody talks about renewals. Hey, are they, you know, but it's a fifth paycheck of the month. And we're going to pay it out. We're going to continue to grow. You know, last month, persistency of the business. So write these three numbers down real quick. 90, 80, 70. So here's your goal. And simple math, right? Your goal each week, but each month for you and your team is 90% net to gross. And then the 80 is 4 month retention. I know some of y'all just got started, don't even know, you know, how to spell retention. Totally understand. So just know there's a report and your report card comes out the first day of the month. You can go in Impact and look at your report card. So you look at your report card, 90% or more net to gross, A plus, you're rocking. So 90% net to gross, 80% 4 month retention, and then 70% 13 month retention. So that right there, those three numbers are your profit center and profitability. So you can monitor those on your, what they call APMP report on a monthly basis. You're in leadership, you review your teams first. And retention should not be a surprise to anybody. It doesn't just sneak up on you. I mean, I can project the next 3 months retention on anybody and say, yes, you're trending nice, or hey, you need a little bit of work. Right? So just know that. Check your report card the first day of every month. In your boxers, all good, from Impact, right? And log in and say, hey, what's my report card? You know, what did Mike say? 90, 80, 70. We know the trends. If you keep a 90% net to gross, you should shake out an 80% or above 4 month retention, which is 70% 13 month, and you're rocking. Another stat is like last month. So persistency of the business, meaning of the business that got issued, how much is still on the books after 13 months? So last month, company history, we hit the all-time, in over 50 years of business, and we hit the all-time highest persistency in company history. I think it was 83.27%. So is it working? Yes. Is it very profitable business? Yes. And virtual, right, is here to stay. So I would just say, you know, on virtual, it's a little different, you know, because you're not, right, like in their face, smelling their breath, seeing what's going on, seeing the medicine cabinet, any of that. But so you have to take a little more steps doing virtual, right, to keep your quality and retention up. So that makes sense. So I'm going to be here for the next few days, and I'll sit down with you. I'll go through your numbers. I'll help any way I possibly can, because Wednesday, when I leave and go back to Texas, I'll make an impact on you. But also, you know, and I already mentioned, you know, this business. I mean, it comes down to those four pillars, but you can't complicate this business. I mean, you're going to work hard, right? But where else in the world can you wake up after 5 years and say, all right, you know, I mean, some people have house payments already, right? But all right, I got my car covered. I mean, your main two bills are your car and your house, right? And then after 10 years, you know, you're going to work hard no matter what or where you go. You know, some people probably, you know, like stayed at a company 20, 30 years and they don't even have $5,000 a month coming in, you know, to retire. And that's hard work as well. So, what else? Oh, and then another note too, next year, because we're hitting all-time records, we haven't changed, you know, the minimum on our four-month retention. It's going to go up a point next year. So you already know, you heard it from me, but it shouldn't be an issue, because if you're at an 80% four-month retention, you're golden anyways. I mean, those, you don't want to shoot for minimums, right? But they have those there. I mean, right now, company minimum is 73% to get full bonus, all that. But the company's retention is 78%. So we're saying you can be 5 points below the company average and still get full bonus. So, all right. And then also, and I'll give Gio, you know, when Waco calls, right, and verifies the apps, I can give you the script. I already know what they're going to ask your applicants. So if you prep your applicants, you know, for this, you know, the questions that they're going to ask, right? So there's no surprises, right? Who's gotten a cancellation on a QAC call, right? Because maybe they weren't prepped for it. I'll give you the script. I'll give him the script and you can copy it, right? Of what Waco is going to ask. But the second thing is too, when you're going through, you know, apps and everything, just don't take any shortcuts. Meaning, I went through some of y'all's QAC calls the past few days, and it was alarming, you know, prescriptions left off, like, in medicine cabinets, like somebody left off 6 prescriptions that they were mysteriously, but Waco got it on a QAC call, you know, so, you know what, you know, cutting corners, right, gets you cut short, right, so just expose everything, because home office will find it. They're checking every app on a RX history, meaning any prescription that the applicant has ever filled at any pharmacy in the US, they're fine. So just know that. So it's better to expose it, you know, on the app, so the underwriters, I mean, you know how many apps we get in a week? I mean, we're rocking. I mean, smoking. I mean, some apps. So any guess how many e-apps in a given week underwriting gets? 17 to 20,000 a week. So talk about, there's 111,000 right now in underwriting. So, right, so I can tell you this, you know, you want your policies underwritten quicker, right? Just expose everything, no surprise, bam, they don't have to call, do an RX history, any of that with the client, right? Be straight up. So I'm gonna be here, you can get with me. I'm here to help make an impact. On anything, quality, retention, any of that. It doesn't even have to be quality retention. It's all good. I've been around, been in the agency for 14 years and home office for 3. So, yep. Thank you. Y'all good? Thank you. All right, let's go.
Thank you, Mike. Thank you. Who likes renewals? Huh? So I always say, if you ever think about quitting, always go back to the reason why you started in the first place. That's the easiest thing. And the reason why I started in the first place was residual income, right? So I'm glad this man is here to make sure we set off our career from the beginning with that. So we're going to close it down here with just a quick little video. And before we play this video, I just want to ask you guys, what's your why? What is your why? What's your why? What's your why? Why? Why are you here? Why are you doing this? What is your fuel? What is your passion? What is your why? Every single morning when you wake up, you need to ask yourself, what is my why? Why am I doing this? And you need to fill up your fuel tank with the passion to drive you throughout your day to get you to your goals, right? So what is your why? What is your why? So play this quick video and we'll break here really quickly after this video. This is a quick one. It's one of my favorites though. Buster Douglas.
Just another day at work for Mike Tyson. He looks almost bored as they call to the center of the ring by the referee. The stage is set. We're set to go. Bob Sheridan here. You see Mike Tyson in the black trunks, traditional, and Buster Douglas.
Up until this point, Mike Tyson has never been knocked down, right? And up until this point, everybody that Mike Tyson knocked down never got up. Go ahead, play. So backstory on that, you guys know, is Mike Tyson has never been knocked down, right? And anytime he ever knocked anybody down, they never got up. So this is the eighth round, and Buster Douglas goes down, and everybody counted him out. And he got up with 9 seconds to go, saved by the bell. The announcer was like, regardless of what happens, Buster Douglas really put on a good show today. Already, like, counted him out, right? Because you have to, you know, after what you've seen. And then he ends up knocking Mike Tyson out and winning, right? And they asked him afterwards, what happened, you know? How are you able to get up? And if you guys know this, that his mom told everybody. He said, my son is going to knock out Mike Tyson. So he told him. But his mom was sick. Two days before the fight, his mom passed away. When he was laying on the ground and he couldn't get up, he said, my mom told everybody that I'm going to knock out Mike Tyson. You better get your ass up and knock him out. Right? So I asked before this video, I asked you, what is your why? Because if your why is big enough, no matter how hard you get hit, if your why is big enough, if it's strong enough, it's going to give you the energy, the passion, the strength, and anything else that it takes to not only just get back up, but to get up and knock whatever the heck knocked you down out. Right, guys? So let's dive into our why a little bit more this week, and let's use the push through, guys. Thanks again. Let's rock it today.